Hi, I'm Box.
I'm Breakable.
I'm Couch Guy.
And you're watching the Two Smart Guys show.
Yay!
And we bring you a weekly variety show of hacking all kinds of wonderful electronics and expanding their capabilities.
And avoiding their warranties.
Beyond the original manufacturer's intentions.
Yes, and which one are we covering today?
Whee!
Whee! Oh, he did do it. That was like a whip.
Yeah, we're showing you how to back up your games.
Yes,
because if you've got children, they use them for various things.
Things. Skiing. Shoving multiple things into one slot.
Yeah. All of the above.
Yeah. Yeah. So, we're going to...
Steps tool.
What the hell?
Pull it out, stood on it to try. Thought it was going to get him higher on. Yeah.
So, it's a necessary in our case.
Yes.
So, I have installed USB Loader onto my Wii, which will enable it to back up my games and play games from a USB mass storage device. Big fat warning. We don't take our word for it. If you get caught, no. According to the recent DMCA ruling...
We recommend you read the old DMC and the new exemptions.
Yes. There are... exemptions for bypassing DRM for your fair use for media.
What Raggable's trying to say is this may or may not
Some
be
of the
perfectly...
things may be very hard to argue in a court of law.
Yeah, don't sue us if you want to try this.
We're not responsible for what you do. Thank you.
Ever.
And yeah.
Except for that one time.
No. Anyways, you want to get into this?
Yeah, so how do we do this? What are the steps that we need?
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is get a few things.
Oh, right. So, a Wii.
Very good.
Check.
And secondly, we're assuming the starting point for this procedure is you have the Homebrew channel installed.
Yes.
That's the starting point.
You need to watch the last episode.
Yeah, on jailbreaking
the Wii. On jailbreaking the Wii.
Although it's commonly referred to as just hacking the Wii.
Yeah.
Either way,
the last episode, twosmartguys.com, if you don't have it done, that's actually step zero.
twosmartguys.com /smash-stack.
Yes, and there are other methods for getting the Homebrew channel, Banner Bomb, the Twilight hack, if that's still relevant.
Not on newer stuff, but if you've previously done it, it's all good to keep going from this point on.
Okay. So step one, we're going to download all the necessary files. This is the WeHack Wii package, the HackMe installer, and the updated version of .me. We're going to run the HackMe installer to install BootMe, but instead of using a Twilight hack or something like that to run the installer, we're going to take the ELF binary file from the extracted contents, and we're just going to throw that into a new folder under the apps folder so that the Homebrew channel can recognize it and run it. So now that we have the HackMe installer on the SD card, we can launch it from the Homebrew channel. And we're going to use this to install just BootMe. Select continue. Select BootMe. And we're going to install BootMe, preferably as a boot 2. This will install BootMe into the boot memory of your Wii, and it will reside there permanently, pretty much brick-proofing your Wii as long as you have a backup of your Wii's NAND flash. All Wiis prior to November 2008 have an exploit in their boot 1 code that allow you to install BootMe onto the boot 2 sector of the memory. But if you have a newer Wii, they fix that exploit, and there's nothing you can do about it right now. So you have to install BootMe as an iOS. But you should still be able to back up your Wii with BootMe as an iOS. It's just, I'd trust a boot 2 more so than an iOS BootMe. So it's installing the necessary files onto the SD card, which BootMe requires. It'll install into boot 2 just a little bit. And so now every time your Wii boots up, it'll look for those BootMe files on the SD card. And it'll run them, and it'll display a different screen before anything else. And the way we navigate around this screen is we use the power button to select a different option, and we push the reset button to select that option. So what we want to do now is back up the Wii's NAND flash. So power over to the gears and push reset. And the option in there, what we want is the little chip pointing with a green arrow to the SD card, back up push select to start that process, and you'll get a nice GUI showing the progress. And it'll take about, you know, 5-10 minutes. Go grab a coffee, pop, beer, whatever it is you do. And then after that, your Wii's NAND flash has been backed up. And we're going ahead and we're going to transfer the WeHack Wii package contents over the SD card. We can overwrite the existing apps folder because we don't need the HackMe installer. And then we'll go back over to the Wii with that. And we're going to launch the Homebrew channel. And this time we're going to select .me. And with this, we're going to install System Menu 4.2, essentially downgrading. And the reason that we're doing this is for compatibility reasons. So in the .me menu, we're going to select use iOS 58 plus blah, 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 prod. And what this is doing is, as far as I understand, loading a patched version of iOS 58 into memory. Nothing's permanently written, but this version of that iOS does have a few exploits that we can use. So after we've installed that and we're using that iOS, we select System Menu. And you can see that we're currently at 4.3. We push left to select 4.2, push the plus button to install it, and it'll go out there and fetch a few files. It's going to download and install iOS 70, which it says 4.2 needs for whatever reason. I don't know why. And after that one's installed, it'll download and install 4.2. So now that we are at System Menu version 4.2, we can go back out, go back into iOS, BC, MIOS, and we're going to install iOS 36. So we cursor over to the left, select iOS 36, and select version 104.2, which has the fake sign ES identify. And then we push the plus button to install that version, actually downloads it from the mothership, installs it. And as you can see from the screen that we go to next, we can see that it's currently installed, version 104.2, that has the fake sign and the ES identify exploits, which we will use later on to install CIOS. As up until this point, we used iOS 58 to get to this point. And now we're going to use .me to navigate around all the different installed iOS versions and delete stub versions. You can see the stub listed in the upper right-hand corner for the current installed version. Cursor down, select that version, push minus to uninstall. And deleting the stub files gives us the room to install CIOSs. But as you can see, there's iOS 36, TrueCode, ES identify, and that will let us install CIOS 222 and 249. So back at the Homebrew channel, CIOS 222, we're going to select iOS 36. We're going to install it as 222, and we're going to do a merge of 38 and 37. And then after this one finishes, we're going to install CIOS 249. Once again, select iOS 36 as the launching point, or with the exploit. Select the WAD installation, which is the default, and that installs everything necessary for USB loader. But what you also need for USB loader to work is a compatible USB hard drive, preferably formatted with WBFS. And I know USB loader supports different file system formats, but the most compatible is WBFS. So the tool that I used was WBFS Manager 3.0 for Windows. So go ahead and launch that, select your drive, then click format, and you have a formatted WBFS drive. And you can plug that back into your Wii. And as you can see, Pox here has a slew of games already installed. We can launch a few. Yay! And if we pop in a new disk, at the main screen of USB loader, it'll pop up and say, do you want to install? Yes! And that will transfer it over to your USB external hard drive.
So, yeah, that was pretty easy.
As painless as it was,
that's how you get it out of your Wii.
It sounds complicated. It wasn't that bad.
No, if you need help, you can go back to our website, twosmartguys.com, and follow the instructions step by step.
Yeah.
And it's easy.
The only thing that's really going to be different is if you're installing BootMe as an iOS.
Right. If you have a newer Wii, it'll be slightly different, but not a big deal.
Yeah. So that's the only difference.
So I know it's you're kind of cold out here in the weather.
Yeah, I could use a jacket or something warm.
Like a cool hoodie or something.
And speaking of custom things. like custom firmwares. What about custom t-shirts?
Hey, a custom hoodie.
Custom hoodie. Where would you go for a custom hoodie?
How about Zazzle?
Zazzle.
Why can't somebody buy me something from Zazzle to keep me warm? Please help me keep warm. Go to Zazzle.com and use our code to save.
You're going to save this much
using
with this
code.
Keep me warm. I can't remember our code and how much it is now. They changed our code on us, so I can't remember.
Don't even try. It's going to be right
this
here.
This much with this code.
Yeah.
Okay? Just do it. Because every time we say it, someone puts it on the coupon site, and then we lose it, and they have to change it. So this much, this code. Enjoy. Zazzle's awesome.
Keep me warm.
Yeah, give them a shot. It helps us out. Helps you out. You get to save money. So
and they, you know, they've got new stuff coming up. They're gonna have iPads and iPod custom cases soon.
Ooh, really?
Yeah.
Ooh,
that's
nice.
On their. I just went and looked at their stuff because I like their stuff. And their homepage. It's right there on their homepage. It says new, coming too soon. iPhone and iPad cases.
Are they?
Custom.
Ooh.
Do they do jello skins, or do they have anything like that?
You saw the
go to the website and find out for yourself.
Hey, guess what? You can find out how to get your own.
All right, so
tune in next week.
Tune in next week with a new something.
Bye.
Bye.
See you guys next week. Bye.
This has been a Two Smart Guys production.